So Tokyo Redux took me a long time. It was the third book of a trilogy. It actually took me 10 years to write, and then there was a delay in publication because of the COVID, the pandemic. It took a long time to write because the Shimoyama case, the true case that this book is based on, is for Japanese society something like the Kennedy assassination or the Dreyfus affair. It's a hugely significant crime or incident, and so there's lots of material, fiction, non-fiction, film and manga, and I needed to research and process all that, so the book took a long, long time to write. And so that's why the book is only being published now in 2022. So in July 1949, the president of the Japanese National Railroads was found dead on the railroad tracks in Tokyo, actually quite close to where I live in Tokyo. His name was Sadanori Shimoyama, and he had been given the task of firing 120,000 workers. The American occupation insisted that these workers be communists and trade unionists. So if you were a communist or a trade unionist, you'd be fired. It was a very, very controversial decision, and his body was found on the railway tracks. Some people thought this was suicide, the guilt of having to fire all these men. Other people thought he'd been murdered, maybe murdered by the left wing, and other people thought he maybe been murdered by the right wing. And so this case became quite a controversial case from the minute it began. And so for many, many years, some people have said it was suicide, some people have said it was murder. And in 1964, the case was closed because in Japan at that time, after 15 years, if the case wasn't solved, it was just closed. Okay, so the case remains a mystery in Japanese society. So I've been living in Tokyo since 1994, and the whole reason I wrote the Tokyo Trilogy was to try to understand the contemporary city that I was living in. In 1945, Tokyo was destroyed. In one night, the area in which I lived was bombed and burned to the ground by the Americans, and 100,000 people died. But if you go to Tokyo now, you see this modern, neon, ultra-modern city. And I wanted to know how this city had risen from the ash. And I think one of the key things to understand about contemporary Tokyo is this 7-year period when the Americans occupied Japan. Growing up in England, going to school in England, I had no idea that the Americans had occupied Japan. And actually, for example, the Japanese political constitution, many of the things that are still present in Japan now, the legal system, the education system, the political system, these all date back to the American occupation. Because when the American occupiers arrived, they actually arrived with quite a utopian idea of creating a democracy. One of the most startling things is that the Americans gave the vote to every adult Japanese, man and woman. But actually, the black soldiers in the American army did not have that vote back home. And quite a lot of the black American soldiers who served in the occupation, this caused them to think a lot about what the white American occupation were doing, and it affected them when they went back to America. So it's an incredibly fascinating period in Japanese history, but it's such a short period, and I just think it's relatively unknown outside of Japan. Even in America, it's not that well known now. Another reason the book took a long time to write was it took me a long time to come up with a structure to the book. The structure of the book is now in three parts, and now it seems to me incredibly obvious that the first part should be in 1949, when Shimoyama died. The second part would be in 1964, which is when the case was about to be closed, and also that was the Tokyo Olympics, the first Tokyo Olympics. And that was really a hugely significant moment because that really symbolized Japan being admitted back into the international community. And then the third part is in 1988, 87, 88, when the Japanese emperor is dying, Emperor Hirohito, who is known in Japan as the Showa Emperor, whose reign encompassed all the horrors of the imperial actions of the Japanese army in Asia, the defeat, the bombing and of Hiroshima, Nagasaki, Tokyo, the whole destruction of Japan, and then the economic rebirth. It's all there in his era. And 87, 88 is when that comes to a close. And so these three times were very symbolic for both the Shimoyama case, but also for Japanese society. But it took me a long time to realize that I needed to have a trilogy within a trilogy to tell the whole story. Mm-hmm.